You're watching today's WCCO television with Don Shelby and Colleen Needles. This is the 10 o'clock news on Channel 4.
Now we have a look on the bright side tonight. It is a look ahead in an effort to build a new world. This evening at the University of Minnesota, engineering students began assembling the base to a giant model globe. Tomorrow, elementary school children from all across the state will add panels that they made, which will show countries. And then last week, these kids from Brooklyn Park were working on a part of South America. And tomorrow, they and some 8,000
other children. Young Earth architects are piecing together a planet.
So put that through that hole. Okay, and take your ball driver and change hands.
Each child has helped prepare one of these panels as part of a class project, mapping out and painting surface features.
It was basically kind of a Trojan horse, that we would build something that had the science and math in it, and then kids would bring it into their school and take ownership with it, and then voila, they become engineers.
And under the surface, these students are actually learning a lot.
Mapping, latitude and longitude, scale, what 1 to a million is, scientific notation, all the things that most kids regard as kind of boring are essential to make this project work.
In all, 11,000 students from across Minnesota are taking part in this global effort, contributing more than 1,600 panels.
So we've got quite a bit left to go, a little over half. We've got quite a ways to go.
As the world grows panel by panel, a special lift inside supports the structure. When it's finished, it'll support all 6,000 pounds of planet. Outside, things are taking shape slowly, but after all, they're building a new world.
Geography isn't all that it seems to be. This is a lot of fun, too. Challenging.
For other students, it's the company, not the country, that matters.
It's just neat to do these things with all these people.
When complete, this new world will be exactly 1/1,000,000th the size of Earth. Still pretty impressive.
To me, this is very, very big, and I know the world is a lot bigger, but it's pretty big.
Who says it's a small world after all? With photographer Steve Painovich, Patty Nystuen, Minnesota 9 tonight.
If you'd like to see the New World Project, it will be on display in the Northrop Auditorium Plaza through May 8th.
About geography, math, and engineering, it's also about cooperation. More than 1,600 panels are put in place to get this four-story globe together and get it in place. Each class was assigned a part of the globe to work on in their classroom, and today all those pieces are being put into place. More than 1,600 triangular pieces make up this globe. The triangles are attached by Velcro. The students started about 8:30 this morning. They began with the North Pole, and they're working their way to the South, which in the center of the Earth, a hydraulic system. It raises the Earth by pedal power. Now joining us now are two of the students who worked on the project, Siobhan Clark and Adam Trampy. They're both seventh graders from North Branch. Now, what did you guys learn about this project?
We learned some about science and geography, you know, and engineering. It's interesting the way that it's put together, you know, the idea of making a circular or a spherical object out of triangles, you know.
Now, are you guys interested in becoming scientists or working in the science field?
I am. I'm sort of, because I'm really good at math and, like, science and stuff like that. So I was, ever since I was younger, I wanted to be working in, like, the science field. So I decided I wanted to be a scientist when I got older.
Now, you guys said it was a lot harder than it looked. What was hard about this project?
Well, our group had Finland, and Finland has a lot of fjords and stuff in it, and lots of the lakes and fjords, we had to do a lot of detail very carefully, you know, really small paintbrush work.
Yeah, so it was a lot of hard work. Well, good job to both of you guys. The project will stay here about a week, and then it heads over to the Mall of America so everyone can check out the work of all these students. Back to you guys.
Dave, it sounds like those young students are learning about as much about geography as they are about several other subjects.
Exactly. One of the big things that they're pushing here is
the entire project took months. But this 42-foot globe is exactly 1,000,000 times smaller than the actual Earth. And after talking with some of the students, we found out that this was a lot more than an educational project.
Purple. I need a purple right here.
It's certainly not the traditional way of learning geography, but the lesson is hitting home. In just about 2 hours, these students knew where to properly locate half the countries in the world.
This is a really good way to teach. It's kind of out of the regular curriculum, but it's a good way to bring in geography and math and science and everything.
It's going in a little bit crooked. There we go.
And everything on this globe was done by students. They painted more than 1,600 triangular pieces of plastic, then placed them together with brackets. It's all held together with dual stick tape.
And then run the roller down the edge.
This project had a dual purpose, to be fun and get students interested in science and geography.
I used to not know where anything was. I feel smarter now.
Well, I've always been kind of interested in engineering, and this just kind of made me more interested in it. And I think I'll become an engineer.
Everybody clear on going up? What the heck?
Now, what's inside the center of the Earth? Scaffolding and a bunch of world leaders. No, not Presidents Clinton and Yeltsin, but university students. It's as much their project as it is the children's. The whole idea is to bring attention to the Institute of Technology Week here at the U, while giving younger students a chance to create a brand new world.
The globe will stay here on campus for about a week. And
it goes right there. Align the edge of the panel up with the edge of the Velcro all the way around, okay?
Building a whole new world is not easy. Not only must you put the pieces in the correct place, the framework has to be just right.
Here's some bolts for you guys.
10,000 Minnesota young people have taken part in building a new world. The globe of 1,600 triangular panels makes up the 42-foot globe. That's 1 millionth the actual size of the Earth. In their schools, the students drew their triangles to exact specifications. At the University of Minnesota, they saw how they all fit into the big picture.
Where is that?
It's Afghanistan.
With people power, the globe was lifted. Ben Johnson peddled the weight of the world.
That is tough.
Inside the globe, volunteers make certain all is right with the world. Outside, it seems to be a perfect learning tour and a perfect world. Well, almost perfect.
If you look at Alabama, Alabama came down into the panhandle on Florida.
Oh, so it's wrong.
Yeah, a little bit. I think they're gonna airbrush it.
Here, it's clouds that do the airbrushing. And once done, it did look like a perfect world. A lot of brains went into this project. So did a lot of hope.
You're building a world with no pollution and all other stuff that might kind of ruin a world.